Hello, I'm Mr. Arnicher, a retired lecturer in mythology, preaching Christianity and Sikhism. Gospel is preached, is not taught like letters in these universities. Letters are dead. And unless you have the spirit, which is called Holy Spirit, common sense, you can't make it living to show up the gospel hidden underneath. Gospel is not lying on the surface, it's hidden down. And you have to dig it out with the tool of logical reasoning. And the end product is logos, called His Word. So here I'm doing an exposition of St. Luke 24, verse 44 to 49. This I get from DGO, which is the one of the ministry who send me every day this gospel tract and passages. Then he said to them, "These are my words that I spoke to you while I was still with you, that everything written about me in the law of Moses, the prophets, and the Psalms must be fulfilled." The prophets act like whips. You know you have parliamentary whip and this and that. So prophets also act like whips for the rabbis. When they become hopelessly dishonest and hypocrite, then the prophets become ineffective, as the last prophet on earth, John the Baptist, became. So they did not care for John the Baptist. They threw him out of the temple. And that's why John the Baptist called them brood of vipers. And when they become brood of vipers, that means don't care for the people, hypocrite, then our Father sent His very Son to deliver gospel to the general public, which is forbidden by these rabbis. The gospel is called Oral Torah. Oral Torah because it cannot be written down in ink on paper. So the rabbis only had it, and they will give discourses of oral Torah to the people. And it is always taught through discourses. Nobody can preach oral Torah through writing on the paper as I do, but those people who have this common sense, they will pick it up. The law and the prophets, that is the on this. Luke 16, verse 15 onward. And he said to them, "You are those who justify yourselves in the sight of men, as Judas Iscariot justified himself to once born Peter. Are there such once born stooges?" You know, when Jesus was taken to the Pilate for the judgment, you know, with them they were the stooges of the temple priest. So they said what their temple priest told them to say. Their own say, it was pushed down. Don't open your mouth. Only the rabbi. And same thing happened, you know, the one man locked in the graveyard of the in Gennesaret, where Jesus made 2,000 swine to drown. Same thing happened to him, you know, that he was preaching gospel to the common men, but he was holding them like Jehovah's Witness come to your door knocking, you know. He was doing the same thing. And the rabbis told his stooges, "I'm fed up with that man. He's accusing me this and then calling me hypocrite, and lock him in the silence of the graveyard. He was locked there, but as the gospel is such, you know, it gave is such a great urge in you to preach, he was breaking the chains, he was setting himself free and going again to the people to tell them, hey, look, listen to me. He is a hypocrite. But they won't listen to me because their ears were deaf and their tongues were dumb. You know, Jesus opened the ear of the person with the putting finger in his ear. These dumb and deaf people, you can find them in the monastery today. The abbots tell them, don't take anything from anybody. Only what I tell you, listen to me only. And that keep the people dumb and deaf. The same were these temple priests were doing, making the people dumb and deaf, not to listen to anyone. So these miracles have meaning behind it. So with all this background, you know, but God and his twice-born laborers, those who are like atheists, you know, who are not satisfied with these, what they are doing in churches, the remnants, know your hearts for what which is highly esteemed among men. Now the remnants, Jesus told them, the remnants, you know, there are very few people, they know your hearts for what which is highly esteemed among men, as the Pope and Archbishops are today, is detestable in the sight of God. So, you know, Pope, how many stooges he have, and how they like him, you know, wherever he goes, a big crowd follow him, like Billy Graham, you know, big crowd followed him. He will say prayer. What prayer has to do with God? God is within us. He knows everything. He's omniscient. Prayer used to be for the once born people, when Yahweh, our Heavenly Father, he is demiurge, not real. When Yahweh was kept alienated from the God, from the people, they won't let him even write his name, never mind to know him. And our Father is supernatural. Yahweh is in God of nature. Our Father is supernatural of our souls. And how will they let the Rabbi know the name of the supernatural Father when they don't let the name of the natural Father, Yahweh, to be known? That is, how could Queen be the head of the Church of England when Jesus proclaimed onefold? You know, there's too much hypocrisy, and I'm exposing these ones here. The very one, when Jesus had one shepherd, one fold is Church of God, and our shepherd is our Bridegroom Christ Jesus, and such Church of God will not kill people to glorify him. You see, these cenotaph in the plates in the churches. The following soldiers died in World War I, World War II to glorify God. What type of God was that? It wasn't our Father. Such Church of God will not kill people to glorify him, as the people of Church of England and other churches do, to serve them in the fashion of the, sorry, do but to serve them in the fashion of the Salvation Army people serve God. They love the poor people, rejected by the society. They take them. And when their soldiers died, they said they died for king and country. And those who died during the wars, they died for king and country. That is what they proclaimed. And that's what they have written down, you know, in November, Remembrance Sunday in November. They are a dog-collar priest in the Church of England. They will say they will glorify God. And our salvation of people will say they died for king and country. So who is nearer to the God? Salvation of the people. But the Church of England rejected them because they are not of their fold. St. Paul's Cathedral have statues of soldiers, viceroys, proclaiming them they died to glorify God. And our brother William Booth of Salvation Army, people nowhere to be seen there because he did not belong to that fold. He belonged to the fold of our father. The law and the prophets were proclaimed until John. So I will leave it here. And